yesterday we have discussed the mean value or expectation value of in terms of energy is equal to the minus 1 upon z curly z upon curly beta, and mean square value of E square, mean value of E square is equal to the 1 upon z curly 2 z upon curly beta square. This is equation number 3 and this is the equation number 4. On differentiation of equation 3 with respect to beta, curly upon curly beta of E is equal to minus 1 upon z curly 2 z upon curly beta 2 minus differentiation of 1 upon z, this is the plus 1 upon z square curly z upon curly beta into curly z upon curly beta. Taking negative sign on both sides, minus curly E upon curly beta is equal to, this term will become positive, so 1 upon z curly 2 z upon curly beta square, and minus 1 upon z curly z upon curly beta and then whole square. This term from equation number 4 and this term will equivalent to the equation number 3, that is minus curly E upon curly beta is equal to the, that is the average value of E square, and minus this value is equal to the average value of E and then whole square. Actually this is the mean square deviation in terms of the energy, that is the del E of whole square and then its average value. This is equation number 5, because the mean square deviation of any quantity, that is the n, del n square and its expectation value is equal to the average value of square value, that is the n square, and minus n bar its whole square. We have studied this equation from yesterday. So replacing the n, this is the mean square deviation in terms of n, and this is the mean square deviation in terms of the energy. Therefore, delta n is replaced by the delta E. Now, remember equation number 5. Equation number 5, what is? Minus curly upon curly beta of del E is equal to the del E square and this value. As we know that the specific heat at constant volume, which is represented by Cb, and is equal to the curly upon curly T of E. Since we know that the CV is equal to the DE upon DT. Therefore, or this term can be represented as curly upon curly beta of E into curly beta upon curly T. Since beta is equal to the 1 upon KT, so curly beta upon curly T is equal to the minus 1 upon KT square. Therefore, this equation become from equation 5, curly E upon curly beta is equal to the minus del E square and into minus 1 upon KT square, or simply this is equal to the del E square plus 1 upon KT square. Del E square and its average value or mean value upon KT square. This is the specific heat at constant volume CV equation number 6. That is, from equation 6, mean square deviation in terms of energy is equal to the C V into K T square. For large number of particles, the average value is near about the any quantity is equal to the that quantity. That is, the average value of energy is equal to the energy. So, from equation 7, del E square and its average value divided by E square, what we get is equal to the CV into KT square upon E square, because at that large number of particle this value is equal to the this one, that is, and we have CV is equal to the NKT. Sorry, since E is equal to the NKT and CV is equal to the DE upon DT, that is, this is equal to the NK. So, CV is equal to the NKT, that is the NKT into KT square upon E square, that is the N square, K square, T square, or simply we can say that del E square upon E square is equal to the 1 upon N. This term as equation number 8. So from equation 8, what will be observed? Del E upon E is near about is equal to the n to the power minus 1 by 2, taking under root on both sides. This equation basically defines the standard deviation, the deviation of standard value from the mean value, or we can say that this term is known as the fluctuation in energy. It's directly proportional to the n to the power minus half. Now if n is equal to the 10 to the power 22 molecules, or we can say that for large number of particle, the fluctuation in energy is very small, because for large number of particle, that is the order of 10 to the power 22, the fluctuation in energy by using this relation, fluctuation energy is the 10 to the power 11. 10 to the power 11 is large, very small compared to the 10 to the power 22 molecule. So this is the derivation of the fluctuation in energy for case of the canonical ensemble. Now our topic is the fluctuation in ensemble for grand canonical ensemble. Just as in the similar previous study, grand canonical ensemble, basically this is an ensemble in which temperature T, volume V and chemical potential are constant, or an ensemble in which the temperature, potential or chemical potential or volume are constant, such ensemble represented as the grand canonical ensemble. In this ensemble, both number of particle, that is the n, and energy are exchanged with the another system, because in that ensemble the system is connected with the heat reservoir. Therefore our study, our focus mainly on the fluctuation in the number of particle and the fluctuation in the energy in case of the grand canonical ensemble. So starting with the partition function, the partition function in grand canonical ensemble is represented by Z is equal to the summation number of particle in the ith cell is equal e to the power minus beta e energy of the n particle in the ith cell minus n mu, or we can written as Z is equal to the summation e to the power minus e minus n mu upon kT, since beta is equal to the 1 upon kT, and by using kT is equal to the theta, the partition function for grand canonical ensemble is represented as the e to the power minus e minus n mu upon theta, equation number 1. Since our main concern about the fluctuation in the number of particle and the energy, first we concentrate on the fluctuation in the number of particles. So starting as before, the mean particle, the mean number of particles is represented as number of particles are the n, and its mean value is represented as the n bar. What is this? Is equal to the n upon n prime. The average value of any quantity is represented by the, for example, energy value in terms of energy is equal to the E upon N. Here the mean particle of N is equal to the N upon N. These both are N are same, therefore here is the notation N prime. This is equal to the summation I N I N upon N dash. Ni upon n dash, basically this is the probability distribution of ith state, this is the pi. So mean particle is equal to the summation I pi into n, equation number 2. As we know that the probability distribution in case of grand canonical ensemble is equal to the e to the power minus beta e minus n mu upon summation e to the power minus beta e minus n mu. Using 3 in equation number 2a. equation 2. That is the expectation value of n is equal to the pi e to the power minus beta e minus n mu upon summation I e to the power minus beta e minus n mu into n. From equation 2 or first, this term is the partition function, therefore n bar is equal to the n e to the power minus beta e minus n mu upon z. Equation number 4. One upon z e to the power minus beta e minus n mu into n. This is equal to the 1 upon z. This term can be represented as curly upon curly mu e to the power minus beta e minus n mu. Why? Differentiation with respect to the mu, what we get? Exponential term as it is, minus beta and plus n. That is, by taking also beta is equal to the 1 upon kt and this is equal to the theta, and beta is equal to the 1 upon kt and kt is equal to the theta, therefore this is equal to the 1 upon z curly upon curly mu e to the power minus e minus n mu upon theta. Therefore, theta into this term. That is, expectation value of n is equal to the theta upon z, and this is again equal to the z, so curly z upon curly mu. Equation number 5. Or we can easily written as this term, 1 upon z upon curly mu, that is the theta curly upon curly mu of ln z. This is equation number 6. Similarly, Similarly, now we find out the expectation value or average value of the n square. How? N square is equal to the n square upon n prime, that is summation I pi into n square. N square is equal to the pi e to the power minus e minus n mu upon theta into n square upon summation I e to the power minus e minus n mu upon theta. Again, this value is equal to the partition function z from equation 1, that is 1 upon z into n square e to the power minus e minus n mu upon theta. Similarly, in the previous way, we can transfer this term in terms of the differentiation terms curly upon curly mu. How? 1 upon z curly upon curly mu of e to the power e minus n mu. जब हम एक बार डिफरेंशिएशन करेंगे म्यू के रिस्पेक्ट में अपॉन थीटा, तो हमें ऑब्जर्व होगा माइनस एंड प्लस एन अपॉन थीटा, और हम अगेन इसका डिफरेंशिएशन करेंगे कर्ली अपॉन कर्ली म्यू के रिस्पेक्ट में, तब हमको मिलेगा एन स्क्वायर अपॉन थीटा स्क्वायर, और एन स्क्वायर हमारे पास ऑलरेडी है, तो ये टर्म हो जाएगी सिंपली वन अपॉन थीटा स्क्वायर वन अपॉन जेड, एंड दिस टर्म दैट इज एन स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू द वन अपॉन जेड again show here n square is equal to the 1 upon z differentiation with respect to the mu, that is the curly upon curly mu e to the power minus e minus n mu अपॉन थीटा. जब हम एक बार डिफरेंशिएशन करेंगे तो आपको मिलेगा एन अपॉन थीटा, दो बार करेंगे जब हम इसका, तो आपको आ जाएगा कर्ली अपॉन कर्ली म्यू एंड एन स्क्वायर अपॉन थीटा स्क्वायर. देयरफॉर एन स्क्वायर तो हमारे पास है, तो दिस वैल्यू थीटा स्क्वायर, दैट इज एन स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू द वन अपॉन जेड थीटा स्क्वायर कर्ली जेड अपॉन कर्ली म्यू. सो एक्सपेक्टेशन वैल्यू और एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ एन स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू द थीटा स्क्वायर अपॉन जेड एंड कर्ली टू जेड अपॉन कर्ली म्यू. 2. Equation number 6. And from equation 5, n is equal to the theta upon z curly mu curly z upon curly mu, or simply this is the theta curly ln z upon curly mu.